a double lip and single lip can both navigate the same kind of music, but you do have an advantage when you're playing legato and lyrical, very singing passages with double lip, and maybe there's some advantage in stability in playing technical passages when you're playing single lip. Did I say that right? When you're playing double lip, you play the lyrical passages better, and when you're playing single lip, you probably play the technical passages with a little more stability. But again, that depends on how heavy-handed you are. Now let's go on and talk about this specific experience you're having, okay? Well, it says here, also, my teeth dig into my upper lip painfully when I play a double lip embouchure. Is that normal, or am I doing something wrong? Well, you know, you opened your letter by saying you suspect that you're biting when you're playing single lip. The fact that you're experiencing so much pain when you play double lip is a sure indication that you're biting, because there's no way that the jaw should be coming up pressing into the reed and the teeth should be pressing down on the mouthpiece. That is what biting is that upper jaw motion into the reed, pressing into the reed, and the teeth down on the mouthpiece. And just because you take your upper lip under doesn't mean that you abandon that technique, especially if you're used to it and you've been doing it for years and years and years. So the thing with double lip playing, if you'll review those videos, is to create the embouchure opening first as a fixed opening, like a slot in the mailbox, and then always bring the horn to the face, never the face to the horn. If you want to add pressure to the reed and mouthpiece, you always bring the horn to the face, never bring the face to the horn, never close around the mouthpiece to get control. It's always up and in, and that's where you get the thumb stuff. So that's going to help you. In terms of playing double lip, you're a beginner, so you don't have any muscular development up here, and you need some good, firm, cushiony muscles up there to resist the upward-inward movement so you can snug properly and get good control. And that takes a little time. A few things that I might suggest is to rest frequently, and also you can rest the clarinet on your knees. Don't forget to lift, though. You're not completely just putting all the weight of it on your knees, but you can help stabilize the horn. And also, when you play high C, there are a few special fingerings that you can use, and I think I've gone over those in videos. I'm pretty sure that I have. So the main thing is to rest frequently, and you'll find that the embouchure will build up very quickly. And the final thing is very important, is always to play balanced reeds. Well-balanced reeds will really help you develop a double lip embouchure, and it will help you with your endurance in double lip embouchure, and it will reduce the possibility of cutting yourself all the time. So rest frequently, rest the clarinet, use proper fingerings, and make sure that you play well-balanced reeds. Badly balanced reeds actually force you into biting in order to center the sound and make the tone respond. So that's what you want to avoid, is playing those bad, unbalanced reeds. And if you need balanced reeds, try my ATG reed finishing system. They'll virtually assure you of well-balanced reeds all the time. So you don't have to worry about that. Let's see. She asks, well, will the pain go away? Not unless you stop biting. It won't go away. And she says, I have long lips. I imagine you say thick lips, so I can tuck my lip farther over my teeth and press on a thicker part. That's not very cool. The more lip you take over your teeth, the more you're going to damp the sound, and that'll kill the high register. That'll kill the resonance in the sound. You should play with as much lip out as you can, as far as the relationship of lip and teeth. So don't stuff a bunch of lip over there just because it's hurting. That's just another compensation. Learn to bring the horn to the face, never the face to the horn, and you'll be sailing right along. So I think those suggestions should help you very much, and be patient, and you'll be surprised. You know, within a week, a couple weeks, you'll come along amazingly fast. Anyway, I hope this answers your questions, and I hope it helps some of you out there who may have had the same questions but just didn't take the time to write. And if you have other questions, you guys out there, please write, and I'll do my best to answer them. I don't know everything, but usually if I don't know the question, the answer to the question, I know someone who does. So anyway, please don't hesitate to write. I'll do what I can to help you, and subscribe if you get a chance, and let your friends know about our videos, and we can all share as much clarinet knowledge as possible. In the meantime, I'll see you next week.